third grade and had a really good time doing it. I think our kindergarten children have learned a lot, and we're really happy that they can be here to share with us some of the things we've done together.
I'm the third grade teacher, Mrs. Small, and I'm also happy to introduce to you a few of the other personnel that are here in our building. And one is Mrs. Hearn sitting here in the corner. She is the library aide, and also Mr. Beaver, our principal.
As I said, we've had a good time working cooperatively. We've been trying to do a lot of different things between kindergarten and third grade. And the kindergarten children, I think, have learned a lot from the third graders. And I think the third graders have learned a few things from the kindergarten children, too. We hope so. They've worked really well together. They've worked with partners. We've worked together with our classes as a whole. And the children have also worked with partners, third grade partners, and doing several different activities, working cooperatively. Also, within our own classroom. So the third graders have done a lot, and Mrs. Small will tell you some of those things in a minute. But they
article about the whole incident. Back here on the bulletin board was written by Katie and Jenny, and Katie is going to read that apology letter for you.
Dear Three Bears, I am sorry for breaking into your house and eating your porridge. I am sorry for messing up your bed and breaking me biscuit. Your friend, Voila.
Our second apology letter was written by Ryan and David. David is going to read our story. He wasn't planning on doing this, but Ryan is ill this morning, and David's going to try to do it the best he can.
Dear Three Bears, I'm Goldilocks. I'm sorry for breaking into your house. I'm also sorry for breaking Baby Bear's chair and eating her cards and messing up her bed. I'm sorry I sleep. I'll try to come back later. I'll try to buy a new chair for Baby Bear. Your friend Goldilocks.
One of the things is a kindergarten song. But I need to add that we did a really difficult number, which is the finishing program that Mrs. Small will explain to you. And the kindergartners were very, very hard to learn that. So you'll see, you can now see a third grade song. This a kindergarten song, I'm sorry, third grade, for sure. We had a starter yesterday. We still have that starter. You moved your spot. Okay. Ready? This is the song called The Fuzzy Bear. One, two.
Goldilocks goes into the three bears' house. Goldilocks learned everything. The scene of the crime was in the woods at the three bears' house. It was horrendous. It happened in the morning while the three bears were taking a walk. It happened approximately at 9:30 a.m. date June 10, 1978. The girl Goldilocks jumped out the window, but they caught her and made her pay for anything she broke or messed up. The bears said news reporters were all over the place. After that, she had to go to court. She got punished for breaking and entering the house. She got 2 years in jail. The bears never saw again.
We learned a lot about echo songs in music class. So we decided to try one. This is an echo song called Three Bears Walking, and it tells very quickly and briefly the story of the three bears in music. The third grade will do the first line, and the kindergarten will echo it. So you will hear the children singing, but you will hear them singing separately on the song. So am I starter ready? Everyone ready? One, two, three.
Three bears walking.
Scared and ran away into her house. Then she had to go to jail, and then her mom had to come get her. She was grounded for 4 months, and then she had to have a talk with her mom, and she lived like that for the rest of her life.
Of a rap song and a singing song. This was kind of difficult, but I think everybody enjoyed learning it, didn't you?
Yes.
Even the kindergarten children finally did get to learn it. Basically, if you listen closely, it tells the entire story from beginning to end of Goldilocks and the Three Bears.
Yeah.
special people. We wanted to do something very special for you. So we've been working very hard to show you how important you are in all of our lives. You're certainly important in my life as well as your children. We'd like to thank you for all the good things you do for your children. I'd sure like to thank you for all the support you've given me on you. And also all the support you've given our Mountain View Cooperative. It's been really nice to see so many of you come out to meetings and be very active and very involved. And it's a very, very important part of our school. Now, we'd like you to sit back, relax, and let us entertain you. Are you ready?
Yeah.
We'd like to begin our program with a little poem. It has some motions, and you all know the motions, so don't forget to do them. This is called In All the World. In all the world,
there is no other as dear to me as you are, Mother.
The next song we're doing, you should truly appreciate. You should even appreciate the title. The children want to tell you the title for this because they love this song. It's called Nobody
Knows But Mother.
This is true. Ready?
How many buttons are missing today? Nobody knows but Mother. How many boys are home in her way? Nobody knows but Mother.
How many mothers she's home in her row?
Nobody knows but Mother.
How many times does she tie a bow?
Nobody knows but Mother. We are so happy that you're here today.
There's
nobody like our mothers.
Hi, come on in. He'll come and get you. Thank you, Wayne, for looking out there and seeing your mother. We'll wait for you, Wayne. We're very glad you can make it. Aren't we, Wayne?
Yeah.
Right. Okay. This is the part of our program that we call our silly song section. We had to put this in. The first song we'd like to do for you is one the children learn to spell a word for. We've been working very hard on the language arts area in kindergarten. I know you're aware of the fact that they're learning to read, so I'm sure they're reading things for you. We're also learning to spell for fun, aren't we? And in this song, they learn to spell one of my favorite kinds of candy. You'll recognize it right away. Do you have one?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Ready? Okay.
L-O-L-L-I-P-O-P spells lollipop.
Say hello, hello. If your toes are down below, say hello.
Teddy Bear Tea. You heard an Echo song then, too. This is another one. It's very simple, and it has a very simple title called We Love Mothers. Now, the girls had the tough part of this, and we only have 6 girls in our class. If you notice, we have a lot more boys in our class than we have girls. Our girls needed to learn the words. Our boys had the easy part because they're being the Echo. They love that part. Our girls need to remember all the words. With me, girls?
Yes.
We love mothers. Remember, girls, don't sing with boys. And boys, don't sing with the girls. But you can all do the motion part.
We love mothers. We love mothers. Yes, we do. Yes, we do. Thank you, mothers. Thank you, mothers.
For your love.
For your love.
We love mothers.
We love mothers.
Yes, we do.
Yes, we do.
Thank you, mothers.
Thank you, mothers.
For being you.
For being you.
This is a very short poem, but it's a little too long for the children to learn all the other things we learned. I'm going to read 2 very short verses, and they're going to join me in the 3rd verse. Remember, the word you want to join me with is...
It's poppy.
Kittens are soft and covers at night. Softness is furry and whisper light. Softness is floating like feathers in the bird. Softness is cuddling like singing words.
Poppies are soft. And baby sisters and brothers, but nothing is ever as soft as our mother.
We have 1 last song and 1 last little poem, and we will be concluding our program. This last song has a very appropriate title of Happy Mother's Day to You. And we want you to remember that this is your special day with us, but Sunday is also your special day. We certainly hope that you all have a great Mother's Day on Sunday as well as today with us. Ready for Happy Mother's Day to you? Remember the tune is... We tend to want to sing this song to the tune of Happy Birthday, if I don't remind them, and remind you too. Ready?
Happy Mother's Day to you, day to you, day to you. Happy Mother's Day to you. Have a happy day. This day was made just for you, just for you, just for you. Today was made just for you. Happy Mother's Day.
We'd like to conclude our program with a very short poem called I Like the Way You Look. And before we do conclude this, I'd like to tell you that the children have been practicing a bow. Girls have been practicing a curtsy. The boys have been practicing a bow, and we'd like to do that after we conclude the program. We'd like to do that for you. We want to do it together, so you'll be hearing us count 1, 2, 3 when we do that. So if you're wondering what's going on, no bomb is going off or anything like that. It's just that we're getting ready to do the bow, right? And then we want to say one last thing before we go back to our desks. After we do this poem, the children are going to come back and sit down with you, and then we're going to be inviting you to come back to our refreshment table, Hewitt Pond. I do believe that they voted that this is the favorite part of the program. I asked them what they liked best, and what did you tell me this morning?
Eating.
All right.